All right, guys, so let's get into the answer. Again, I'm hoping that you tried this on your own because it's great practice. So what we're going to do is we're going to go one letter at a time and just say what all the pKas are of those atoms. And then what we're going to do is we're going to follow the rest of the directions in the question, which are to rank them in order of increasing acidity, meaning that we start off with the worst acid. So what would be the pKa of this hydrogen right here, the hydrogen that's attached to the O? Well, there's a few things that might come to mind. There were actually two functional groups that we learned their pKas of that had OH. One was an alcohol, ROH. Remember that ROH we said is about 16. And then we also had carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid was COOH, and we said that that one's a little bit stronger of an acid. It has a pKa of 5. So this just goes back to functional groups. Is molecule A, that proton, is it an alcohol or is it carboxylic acid? Well, this alcohol, this OH, is two carbons away from a carbonyl. As you'll notice, this is a carbonyl here, right? That's a carbonyl carbon. So I have another carbon and then I have an O, okay? So that means that this is not a COOH because this would have required that the O was directly attached to the carbonyl carbon. And as you can see, there's that red carbon in the middle that's not making it directly attached. So going in, once again, to functional groups, this is an alcohol. This is not a carboxylic acid. So this would have a pKa of around 16. Let's go on to B. B is excellent practice because this H is in a very special situation. It is an N that's attached to an H. Now remember that there were two pKas we learned for NH. We learned that an N attached to at least one H has a pKa of 38. That's what we call an amine. But if that N has an H and it also has a positive charge on it, that's no longer an amine, that's called an ammonium or an ammonium derivative, and it has a pKa closer to 10. So which one of these is it? Is it the amine, the neutral nitrogen, or is it the ammonium, the positively charged? You guys got this. This is actually an ammonium derivative, so this would have a pKa of right around 10. Okay? Awesome. So hope you guys are 2 for 2 so far. Let's keep going. So this H here, a little bit tricky because of where it's placed, but remember guys, I told you there's this very special location right next to the carbonyl called the alpha carbon, okay? So the alpha carbon is unusually acidic. Any hydrogen that comes directly off of an alpha carbon, meaning that it's directly next to a carbonyl, is really acidic. And this one has a pKa of what? 20, around 20. Okay, now you might be wondering, Johnny, isn't the other side also alpha? Sure, it is. This is also alpha. But notice that this alpha carbon doesn't have any hydrogens on it. It has an OH. And the OH is just, that has a pKa of 16 because that's just an alcohol. It's not special. An alpha carbon is only special if it has a hydrogen directly coming off of it, which is going to give it a unique pKa of 20 as opposed to much higher for other types of carbons. Okay, which we're going to look at now. So let's go on to D. D is just a CH, okay? But the pKa of the CH is going to depend on its hybridization. So what is the hybridization of the carbon it's attached to? Is the hybridization sp3, sp2, or sp? Which one is it? Recall that sp3 CH is going to have the highest pKa. It's going to be roughly 50. So it's one of the worst acids possible. It's a terrible, terrible acid. Recall that sp2CH was equal to what? You guys remember? 44. You can just look above. We wrote it down. And spCH was equal to much better, is a much better acid, much stronger acid of 25. Okay? So which of these is it? How do you tell the hybridization of that carbon? Guys, you look at the groups. Remember, we've done this before. So you look at the groups. This blue carbon has an atom here, an atom here, an atom here, and then it also has another H here. So that counts as 4 groups because that's 4 different atoms, or 4 atoms total coming off of the blue carbon. That means this is sp3 and it has a pKa of about 50. And then finally, coming to the last proton here, this proton is also a CH. So can I just assume, because this is a carbon here, can I assume that they have the same pKa? No, I have to look at the hybridization again, right? So the hybridization of this carbon here would be what? How many groups does it have? Well, guys, it only has two groups, because the green carbon has how many things coming off of it? Well, it has this carbon here, and it has this hydrogen here. That's it. It has two atoms. That counts as two groups. That's sp. That means it has a pKa of 25. Got it? Cool. Awesome, guys. So that's it for the pKas. Now you have to move on to the next step, which is just to rank these. So which of these is going to be the absolute worst acid? And that's a no-brainer. It has to be D. D is the worst with a pKa of 50. So then which one comes next? Well, by all the pKas that I have written down, it looks like then it's going to be E. E is going to be a little bit better, or actually significantly better at 25. Let's keep going. What's getting more and more acidic? It looks like it's C. C has that alpha proton, so C has a pKa of about 20. Then what do we have? Well, now it's between A and B. A comes next with a pKa since it's an alcohol of 16. Okay? The alcohol always has a pKa of 16. It doesn't matter whether it's alpha or whatever, what have you. The acidity comes from the OH bond, not from the alpha position of the carbonyl. That doesn't really affect the acidity, okay? So just because it's OH, that is going to be a pKa of about 16. And then finally, we have our most acidic, which has a pKa of about 10, and that's your ammonium. And guys, just to point this out, you could have actually used your intuition to know that was going to be one of the most acidic, because notice what's special about B is that it has a positive charge, right? We know that positive charges are usually acidic. It means that they're electrophiles, right? So they're proton donors, okay? So because this had a positive charge, even without knowing my pKas, I could have probably predicted that B was gonna be my best acid, but now we've confirmed it through pKa values. All right, cool guys, so hopefully that made sense. Now let's move on to the next set of practice problems where we're gonna do the same thing, just with a little bit more tricky, smaller molecules.